So next, that is nothing but standard spheres, or generally we'll call it as sphere gap measurement. So normally only sphere gaps are used for voltage measurement. In certain cases, uniform field gaps and rod gaps are also used, but their accuracy is less. So it means that we have, other than the standard spheres, we have point-to-point, point-to-plane, and the plane-to-plane camera configuration in the laboratory that we are going to discuss. So generally, which we are going with the standard spheres. The spar gap breakdown, especially the sphere gap breakdown, which is independent of the voltage waveform. That's why it is highly suitable for all the types of waveforms like DC, AC, as well as the impulse. Even you can use it for the rise time, which is greater than or equal to 0.5 microsecond, means for the impulse and the how we need to do it for the lightning as well. So generally, sphere gap measurement can be arranged either in vertical with the lower sphere is grounded, which you can see to that. This is subjected to the source and this is subject to the ground point. Horizontally with both the spheres connected to the source voltage, or one sphere which is connected to the grounding. So this is the another arrangement which you can see to that. One is nothing but the insulator support. So this is the minimum clearance which is required. And two is the sphere shunk. Okay, this is a shunk, and the third one is the operating gears. Then fourth one is HV connection, and the P is nothing but the sparking point. Okay, so at this point there is a possibility of means the breakdown takes place at this junction. So resulting in there is a formation of the pitting matrix pluses that care has to be taken into consideration. And the D is nothing but the diameter of the sphere. So it is depending upon the diameter, again 6.2, 6.25, okay, different type of the diameter of the spheres we have. And S is nothing but the spacing, the distance between these two electrode. And capital A is nothing but the height of the P above the earth, because we know that when it is subjected to the high voltage, we should have some minimum clearance above the ground. Otherwise, the ground electrode or earth object will lead to that some errors in the reading. Then capital B is nothing but the radius of the clearance from external structures. So suppose if you kept any the electrode or the object, this may introduce some sparking, or it may lead to that there is an errors, or the early breakdown may take place because of this presence of this element. And the capital X is nothing but the high voltage lead should not pass through the this plane within the distance B from the P. So these are the minimum things which we need to keep it in our mind while doing the construction for the horizontal and the vertical placement. So regarding this X, P value, all those things, capital D and the small d and the distance, that the thing we have to take into consideration. And you can see to that there is an this tan, it should be greater than half 1.5 times of the diameter. So if not, there is a possibility of that there is a mechanical instability may take place. So generally, The value of the series resistance, which may varies from 100 to 1000 kilo ohm for the DC, AC, and not more than 500 ohm in the case of the impulse voltages. So in our laboratory, generally which we are using as a water column as a resistive element, okay, so because we need to limit the current which is flowing through the element. In the case of AC peak value and the DC measurement, the applied voltage is uniformly increased until spark or occurs in the gap. So this is agree within a plus or minus 3%. This means that so when we are operating the system, we should not vary directly. We have to vary the auto transformer in a linear way. So this is the meaning of that. In the case of impulse voltage, to obtain 50% of the flashover, two voltage limits differing by not more than 2% are set such that one application of lower limit value, either 2 to 4 flashover will take places, and on the application upper limit values is 8 to 6 flashover will be take places. Means we are considering that. So from 10 to 90% days, or if it is for the 50% days, it should not be differed by 2% days of the set value. For the lower limit, generally we are considering 2 to 4. And for the upper limit, it should be 8 to 6 flashovers. Because there is a possibility of the voltage may, which is varies across, because of the impulse wave, because this is not in the formation of the uniformity. So these are the different set of the readings which we'll consider for the measurement of the impulse voltages. This table will give the different set of the values of A and B for different sphere of the diameter, like 5, 10, 15, 25, okay. So depending upon the spacing, you can select the A and the B values. Then coming to the construction and the assembly. So sphere gaps are made with the two metal spheres of the identical having the diameter D, and with their shanks, operating gears and insulating supports. So generally the sphere gap are made up of copper, brass, aluminium, and the latter is used due to the lower cost. So generally the standard diameter of the spheres are 2, 5, 6.25, 10, 12.5, 15, 25, 50, 75, 100, 150 and the 200 centimeter. So the gapping is designed in such a manner that flashover occurs near the sparking point P, that is nothing but the tip of the standard spheres. The surface of the sphere should be free from dust, grease and any other coating. Make sure that the surface of the standard spheres should be clean but not polished. If there is an excessive pitting occurs due to the repeated flashover, they should be smoothened. So this care has to be taken place for the standard spheres. The dimension of the shanks used, the grading ring used with the spheres, the ground clearance, etc. should follow the values indicated, which is there in the previous table as well in the textbook which is mentioned, or IEEE standards. The series resistance connected should be outside the shank at a distance 2D away from the high voltage spheres of the sparking point. So otherwise, if there is a presence of earth object, or the resistance will lead to that there is an early breakdown, or sometimes the breakdown may increases depending upon the position. And the series resistance which is used to limit the current which is flowing through the element In our laboratory, which are using the water column as a rheostat for the series resistance for the high voltage experiment. So these are the clearances for the spear gaps. For the D, that is nothing but up to means the diameter of the standard spears, 6.5 to 15 likewise. And these are the minimum and the maximum values of the A. Okay, the clearances up to 70 and 90 minimum values, and the minimum values of the B. Okay, the 14S, that is nothing but the spacing of the gap. So this, the table has to be followed while conducting the experiment for the standard spears. Then coming to the factors influencing the spark gaps. Okay, so these are the four things. First one is nearby earth object. Next one is atmospheric condition and the humidity. Next is irradiation. Next one is polarity sensitive and the rise time of the voltage waveforms. So it means that if there is a presence of the earth object, the breakdown strength may varies and is mainly depending upon the atmospheric condition and the irradiation, and it is more sensitive for the polarity, whereas in case of DC, positive and negative, and also is depending upon the rise and the fall time of the waveform. So like, whereas in case of the impulse. Detailed investigations of these different factors have been made and analysis by Craig and Meek, Kufel, Davis and Boulder, and several other investigators. Only some of the four points we are going to discuss, so that is nothing but the first one, the effect of nearby earth object. So nearby earth object, which is investigated by Kofel, by enclosing the earth sphere inside the earth cylinder, means we are the earth object which is going to place onto the spheres. So it was observed that the spark over voltage, which is reduced, is given as delta V is equal to M into log V by D plus C. So this is a percentage reduction. D is nothing but the diameter of earth enclosure, and the D is the diameter of the spheres, and S is the spacing, and M and C are the constant. So what we can observe here is, so there was a reduction which is less than the 2% for the S by D. This is nothing but the spacing and the diameter of the spheres, which is less than or equal to 0.5. And for B and D, this is nothing but B by D, the diameter of the earth enclosure and the diameter of the sphere, which is greater than equal to 0.8. Even for the spacing and the diameter, which is equal to 1, and the earth object and the distance, the diameter, which is greater than or equal to 1, which we can observe is reduction, which is only of 3%. Hence, for the specification regarding the clearance, or which is closely observed that errors are within the tolerance and the accuracy is specified. And for the reduction in the voltage within the accuracy limit, if the spacing and the diameter is kept less than 0.6A, means the constant, the clearance constant in the above ratio, the A is the distance from the sparking point to the horizontal ground. So this A and the B constant has to be taken into consideration. This is the earth object for the standard spheres. So these are the influences of the ground planes for the spark or voltage. So you can see to that by varying the value of the S by D ratio, this influences will go on increasing. So whenever these ratio are increasing, the breakdown strength is also, it is mainly depending upon the ratio, and these are the S by D and the A by D ratio for 1 and 4.2. So what is the conclusion we can make it is, so if there is a ground object which is a presence, so it will influences the breakdown strength will reduces by some percentage. So if it is within the tolerance, then we will neglect, otherwise we have to take into consideration. Second one is effect of atmospheric condition. So in place of directly we can going for breakdown strength, we will make it as breakdown voltage under normal atmospheric condition can be written as V is equal to K into V naught. So V naught is the actual value of the voltage what we got under subjected to the practical condition. K is nothing but is a function of the air density correction factor. So D is equal to P by 760 293 divided by 273 plus T. P is nothing but the pressure, and the T is nothing but P is nothing but the pressure. Okay, T is the temperature, atmospheric temperature. By substituting this value, we can able to get the D, air density correction factor. So corresponding the value of D, or we can write it as D, or the delta, whatever the value. So we can get it as delta or the D value. So if you make it as delta, this is also delta. It is D, it is D. So better we can make it as a delta. Delta, because corresponding these values we can get depending upon the pressure and the temperature. So we can note down the K value. If it is delta is 0.7, K value become 0.72. If it is 0.75, this will become 0.76, 0.8, 0.81, 0.85, 0.86, 0.99, 0.95, 1, 1, 1.0, 1.01, 1.0, 1.09. So in our laboratory condition, generally we will get this the delta value within the range from 0.9 to 1.05. So generally what we are considering is if it is the temperature is varies from 25 to 35, we can say. So by if there is no pressure which is changing by keeping that 760 mm of Hg. So it is subjected to that the delta, what is the corresponding value we got? So it will be remains the same as the K value. I can say it is, if it got 0.9, it is also 0.9. So 0.9 to 1.05 generally we will get. So from this, what we can see to that, by calculating the value of the delta, we will get the K value. K value substitute here, we will get the V is equal to K into V naught value. The spark core voltage increases with the humidity. Then the increase is about, what we can notice is 2 to 3% of the over normal humidity when the range of 8 gram per meter cube to 15 gram per meter cube. So from this we can make the conclusion is that the humidity will affect the with the size of the sphere and is maximum for the uniform fluid gap, and this is nothing but the humidity is increasing with the size of the spheres, and the spark core voltage will increase with the partial pressure of the water vapor in the air. If there is a presence of the water vapor, there is the spark core voltage will also increase, and for the given humidity condition, the change the spark core voltage increase with the gap length. So if there is a presence of humidity and the water vapor, okay, the breakdown strength is going to increasing. As the change in the spark core voltage with the humidity is within 3%, then there is no need to make the correction for the humidity. So these are the waveform that is subjected to the positive and the negative waveforms for the DC, subjected to the DC. So you can see to that at the beginning, so negative polarity is higher than positive at this junction. Okay, so then at the middle, so this is going to be linearization. So when you go on adding these points, so this is subjected to the both the positive and the negative polarity, and this errors means this values will be within the range of plus or minus 2 to 3% errors. So generally we can plot this negative and the positive waveform for 25 centimeter diameter and the 1 centimeter spacing. Next one is effect of irradiation. Suppose elimination across the spear gap by considering that UV light or X-rays, there is a possibility of the easily ionization will take place across the gap. So hence the effect of irradiation is pronounced for the small gap spacing, means we are considering for the small gaps, and for the larger gaps we are going to neglect for this. The reduction is about 20% of the spar core was observed for the spacing of 0.1 to 0.3 for 1.3 centimeter spear gaps with the DC voltages, and for the reduction in the spar core voltage less than the 5% for the gas spacing more than the 1 centimeter, and for the gas spacing of the 2 centimeter or more, it is of 1.5%. Hence, we are considering that irradiation is necessary for the smaller spear gaps of the gas gap spacing, which is less than the 1 centimeter for obtaining the consistent spirals. So this is the nothing but for the smaller gaps, which are considered irradiation is plays an important. However, when it is subjected to the higher gaps in the diameter of the standard spheres, which is going to be negligible condition. However, this is also one of the factors will affect for the abraded strength of the standard sphere subjected to some distance between the two electrodes. Then coming to the last one, effect of polarity and the waveform. So experimental investigation were shown that 6.25 to 25 centimeter. So these are the general diameter of the standard spheres where we are using for the experimental purpose. The difference between the positive and the negative DC voltage is not more than the 1%, what we plotted in the previous concept, that the positive and the negative polarity, these values will be not more than the 1%. For the smaller sphere gaps, the difference, which is about the 8% between the negative and the positive impulses of the waveform 1 bar 50 microsecond. Similarly, for wavefront and the wave tire durations also will influence the breakdown voltages. For the wavefront of the time duration, which is less than 0.5 microsecond, and the tail time less than the 5 microsecond, the breakdown voltages are not consistent. So hence the use of the standard spheres is not recommended for the voltage measurement in that such cases, because it is subjected to that very less of the rise and the fall time. That's why we are not going to recommend for the standard spheres for the measurement under subjected to these conditions. However, there is a difference of the 8% subjected to the negative and the positive polarity in the case of 1 bar 50 microsecond and the 2 centimeter diameter and the lesser than that. So generally in our laboratory conditions, so polarity is not plays a very important role. However, we can observe where there is a small change in values across the positive and the negative polarity. Again, it is mainly depending upon the temperature, pressure, all the parameters. So hence, these are the four things which you need to keep into our mind while subjected to the standard spheres for the measurement of AC, DC and the impulses. So apart from this limitation subjected to the 0.5 and the 5 microsecond for the impulse, generally we are using the standard spheres for the measurement of the AC, DC and the impulse. Next concept is uniform field electrode gaps. Spear gaps, although these are widely used for the voltage measurement and having the limited range with uniform electric field, hence it is not possible to ensure that the sparking always takes place along the uniform field regions. That's why the Rogowski presented a design for uniform field electrode gaps for the spar core voltage up to 600 kV. The spar core voltage in uniform field, which is given by V is equal to A into S plus B into root of S. where A and the B are the constant, S is the gas spacing in centimeter, and V is the spark or voltage. A typical uniform field electrode, which are shown in the figure. Okay, this is the first figure. The constant A and B were found to be around 24.4 and 7.5 respectively at a temperature considering 25 degrees Celsius, and the pressure is 760 torr, that is nothing but cm of Hg. Since the sparking potential is a function of the air density, the spark over voltage for any given air density factor, which is modified as V is equal to 24.4 into dS plus 7.5 root of dS, that's nothing but we are substituting the value of the A and the B value. So this is the equation. So Bruce made a uniform field electrodes with a sine curve in the end region. This is what we can observe in the second figure. So according to the Bruce, that the electrodes with the diameter considering 4.5, 9 and 15 can be used for maximum voltage of 140, 240 and 420 kV respectively. But for the Bruce profile, the constants of A and B are respectively 24.22 in place of 24.4, and in place of 7.50, this will become 6.08. Later it is found that the humidity and the spark over voltage increases. The relationship for spark over voltage was modified with some other equation, that's not here I'm not mentioning. So the final conclusion what we make is the uniform field spark gap is not usually used for the measurement purpose, as very accurate finish of the electrode surface and the careful alignment are difficult to obtain in the practice. So it is very difficult to get for different waveforms. So that's why it is not possible to use for the uniform spark gaps for all the measurement of the voltages. So general way of the acceptance is the standard spheres. Other than that, we can use the rod gaps as well, but it having the some limitation. It has also having some limitation subject to that. So the most of the way which we are using is the standard spheres. Next we have rod gaps. So IEEE, according to the IEEE, this is recognized that this method will give us the accuracy of plus or minus 8% either of a square edge or the circular in the cross section, and the length of the rod which is varies from 15 to 75 centimeter, and the gap spacing varies from 2 to 200 centimeters. So again it is affected by the humidity and the air density correction factors. So in case of the impulse voltage measurement, the IEC and IEEE recommend that horizontal mounting of the rod gaps on the insulator at a height of 1.5 to 2 times of the gas spacing above the ground. So usually one of the rods is usually earthed or the grounded. So this is what the tableau column which is given for on the gas spacing, and there is an which is given correction for humidity of 1/5 microsecond impulse and 1/5 microimpulse wave of either polarity, which is given in that. The spark over voltage for the impulse waves are which is given in the table with respect to spacing and the spark over voltage. So again it is depending upon the value of the this is mainly depending upon the value of the temperature and the pressure exerted between the two columns, so that we have discussed in the previous concept.